Good morning, everyone, and welcome to our weekend update for the Volatility Box. However, in today's video, we're going to put the Volatility Box aside and focus on just our free tools and indicators to do sort of our weekend homework and a broader market update, just because the put call ratio has given us signals that we may want to start to be a little bit more cautious. So here, just so we have the landscape clear, we have our market pulse indicator plotted, which is a free indicator. We have the utility labels that came with it plotted, which will help us look at all of the markets and their components at a very easy high-level view. And then at the bottom, we have the V-score, which is also free. So we'll start by looking at the market pulse indicator, which clearly shows us that we are in a stage of acceleration. No surprise there. We've seen the markets rip up higher despite all of the news that's happened this week. But one thing to keep in mind here is our put call ratio has sunk to 0.67, which we see this label has now turned red, which gives us a sign that we should be a little bit more cautious. Now, if we take a look to see if this has had any trickling down effects, we see that the SPY is still green, the Qs are still green, the Russell's still green, and the Dow is still green. So our bigger markets are still telling us that we're in a bullish scenario. However, we may be starting to see that rollover maybe come through, and that's really just our hint off of the put call ratio. If we go down the line, we do see that some of our ETFs have started to make that roll into our yellow neutral zone. So we have XLP here. We have energy, which no surprise there as well. We have materials, we have XLRE, but the one that I think is a little bit more interesting is retail right here, which you would have expected to currently be green right now, given that we just finished the holiday season. Folks like Amazon had a record holiday season, but we still see that retail currently is in our neutral state on the bubble. But that's just information that we're going to take, right? All of this is just information. We can make educated guesses, but really to try and pretend that we know what will happen next, or that, hey, we are for sure going to get a reversion to the mean, is really just a fool's errand, because we may very well just continue to rip up higher like the market has been doing and just take out all of the shorts, right? Everyone wants to be short right now. We need to find the smart times to actually get short. And so that was our utility labels. Now, if we take a look at our V-score, we see that we're approaching a previous area of resistance. So if I bring out my arrow tool, and this is from last January, but that's also where we topped off on the V-score and started to at least make a reversion back to the mean. However, what we'll also see here is that during this reversion, the real mean that we came down to was just this variable moving average line. It wasn't really a big follow through as the V-score would make you believe, at least if you just looked at this chart alone, right? So that's something interesting. The V-score is showing us that we're in between our second and our third standard deviation line. We see this candle has that bearish pattern to it, and our variable moving average is a little bit away at 3217.67 right now, which may be an interesting spot if this reversion to the mean does continue. The volatility box there will help us at least understand whether or not these sorts of moves are coming when we get those likely trending signals, when we get the opportunity to short, when we see very clear signs that we're, say, breaching both aggressive volatility boxes and maybe even the conservative ones. Those are all of our signs that we'll look at to then start to predict that, hey, this may happen. For those of you that don't have access to the volatility box, you may also be looking at just things like breakouts, right? Looking at trying to see whether or not we break this previous candle's low, which then may be a sign that we're reverting to the mean. You may start to look at the V-score starting to get under the two standard deviation line, which is telling you that we may start to sink down a little bit lower. Some different options that you may be looking at. If we cycle through now the NASDAQ, the NASDAQ also shows this acceleration. We see on the NASDAQ, we are a little bit further away from what would be that variable moving average. If we go to the Dow, we see similar to the S&P, a little bit closer to that variable moving average if we do get that reversion. And then finally, the Russell, whoops. The Russell is the more interesting one, right? Where we do have our stage's acceleration. We're plopped right here, right on our variable moving average. And on the Russell, we see that we fell short of that third standard deviation line. And now currently hovering right over that second standard deviation line, where we may either make a move down to the first or make a move back up to the third. So these are all things to keep in mind. For this upcoming week, this really just serves as information. It's our weekend homework that we're doing to be fully aware, right? We're not expecting the markets to just rip up higher when our put call ratio shows us that we may want to be a little bit more cautious and start looking at bearish scenarios. We also see that some of our markets are starting to roll over, but we're going to need a lot more than just these handful especially our defensive sector. So we'd want to start to see things like XLV start to roll over, which then gives us the sign, XLF even, that, okay, the markets may really start to revert back to the mean. We're not going to call it a correction. We're just going to call it a pullback in probably what is an unhealthy trend at this point, but a pullback nonetheless. And it's not our job to try and predict when this trend will end. It's our job to just participate and trade the activity that we see in front of us that the charts are telling us. And so for us, our main signal right now is that put-call ratio. That's what we're focusing on, and we'll look to this upcoming week's activity with that in mind, keeping that, hey, if we do start to get a little bit more of a sell-off, well, our put-call ratio did give us that warning signal to do so, and we won't try and fight that trend either. All right, hope this video helps, and we'll see you in the next update. Take care, everyone, and have a great weekend.